الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ذلك praise belongs to Allah, who praise him, seek his assistance and forgiveness, and we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of ourselves and the evil consequences of our deeds. While Allah guides, there is no one that can lead him astray, and whoever Allah leads astray, there is no one that can guide him. I bear witness that nothing deserves to be worshipped except Allah alone, and that he has no partners or associates, and I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave servant and his messenger. This morning, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, we would like to discuss al-shart al-khamis, the fifth condition of the conditions or the shurut of La ilaha illallah, from the essay of Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah, entitled Adillatu Shurut La ilaha illallah, the evidences, yani the evidences meaning the proofs from the Quran and Sunnah that these things are indeed conditions for the acceptability or the correctness of someone's declaration of the shahada of La ilaha illallah. In this condition, the fifth, al-shart al-khamis, al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab has mentioned that it is al-mahabbah, that it is al-mahabbah, that is love. Al-mahabbah li hadhihi al-kalima wa lima dallat alayhi wa al-surur li dhalika. And the fifth condition for the correctness or the acceptability of someone's pronouncement of La ilaha illallah is that they must have love for this statement, for this word, the kalima of La ilaha illallah. And they must also have love for that which it indicates, that which it points to. And they must be happy and pleased with all of this, yani its meaning and that which it points to or indicates. And Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he says, mentioning here the evidences, the adilla for this particular condition, and he mentions under this topic three evidences, two verses from the Quran and one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first evidence he mentions, وَدَلِيلُ الْمَحَبَّةِ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَتَّخِذُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ أَنْدَادًا يُحِبُّهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. From Surah Al-Baqarah chapter 2 verse 165, the saying of Allah, and from amongst the people, yani there are some from amongst the people who take others besides Allah as andad, as equals or partners with Allah. Yani they set up something to be worshipped besides Allah to give their love to, like they give it to Allah. يُحِبُّهُمْ كَحُبِّ اللَّهِ. And they love those andad, yani those things that they give their love to besides Allah, they love them just as they love Allah. Yani they love them equally as they love Allah. They offer to them a love that is equal to the love that they offer to Allah. وَالَّذِينَ آمِنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. But as for those who believe, the people of Iman, they love Allah more. They love Allah more than anything else. They love Allah more than the mushrikeen love their idols. And they love Allah more than the mushrikeen love Allah. And if the mushrikeen love Allah, then their love is shared, the love of Allah with the love of their idols. While the believers, their love is purely and exclusively for Allah alone. For that reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the pagan disbelievers, they offer love to other than Allah equal to their love for Allah, while the believers, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. They are more, their love is more for Allah, yani more than anything or anyone else. The second evidence that he mentions is from Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 54, the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَنْ يَرْتَدْ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُ. O you who believe, whoever turns back from his deen, yani whoever apostates and leaves Islam, مَنْ يَرْتَدَّ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ, whoever turns back, Allah has no need of them. He said, فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ. Then Allah will soon bring a people whom he will love and they will love him. يعني هي the محبة in this ayat. It is the love of Allah for those people and the love of the people, the mu'minun, the believers, their love for Allah. And here in this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions five sifat or characteristics of those people whom Allah would bring to replace those who turned away, who apostated, who left the religion of Islam. He said that whoever turns away from his religion, then Allah will bring a people whom he will love and they will love him. أَذِلَّةٌ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَعِزَّةٌ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ يُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلَا يَخَافُونَ لَوْمَةَ لَائِمٍ. That they will be أَذِلَّةٌ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, يعني they will be humble towards the believers. They will be easy and merciful with the believers, while they will be stern and harsh with the disbelievers. And they will fight and strive in the way of Allah, and they will not have any fear of the criticism of those who criticize them. After that, Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab mentioned from the Sunnah proof that Al-Mahabba is a condition for the acceptability or the correctness of one's statement of La ilaha illallah. He said, من السنة ما ثبت في الصحيح عن أنس رضي الله عنه قال. That which is confirmed in the Sahih, here he means the Sahih of Muslim, while in fact this hadith is reported both in the Sahih of Muslim as well as in the Sahih of Al-Bukhari, even if the wording of the hadith is slightly different, few words, expressions which are different having the same meaning. And the hadith is reported from Anas radiallahu anhu that he said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاث من كن فيه وجد بهن حلاوة الإيمان. That there are three characteristics or three qualities. Whoever is found possessing them, then that person will have attained or they will have experienced the halawa of Iman, the sweetness of Iman. Whoever has these three characteristics, then they would have experienced, they would have tasted the sweetness of Al-Iman. And he said they are, number one, أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما مما سواهما, يعني that Allah and His Messenger will be more beloved to them than anything or anyone besides them, يعني anything or anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يعني the love of Allah and His Messenger, it will supersede the love of anyone or anything besides them. وَأَنْ يُحِبَّ الْمَرْأَ لَا يُحِبُّهُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ, and that the person will love someone, يعني they will love another Muslim, another mu'min, but they will not love them for any reason except for the sake of Allah. They will not love them for any worldly thing or any gain that they expect, but they will love them merely, purely for the sake of Allah. Because that person is a believer who loves Allah and who does what Allah loves, and Allah loves that person, therefore the true believer who has tasted the sweetness of Iman will love a person purely for the sake of Allah. And the third of those characteristics, وَأَنْ يَقْرَهَا أَنْ يَعُودَ فِي الْكُفْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ أَنْقَذَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ كَمَا يَقْرَهُ أَنْ يُقْذَفَ فِي النَّارِ. The third of them is that the person who has tasted the sweetness of Iman, they would hate and they would detest to return to disbelief, to kufr, after Allah has saved them from it, just as they would hate to be thrown into the fire. And as they would hate to be thrown in the fire, likewise, they would hate to return to kufr after Allah has saved them from it and guided them to Islam. Here the Shaykh Ubayd al-Jabari, hafizahullah, may Allah protect and preserve him, he says, as for the saying of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, that the condition, this condition is the love of this statement, this kalima, la ilaha illallah, and that which it indicates, and having happiness and joy and pleasure with it, he said that this will be achieved by two things. And in order to achieve the love of the kalima of la ilaha illallah, a person has to fulfill two things. The first of them is ikhlas al-ibada lillahi wahda, la sharika lah. That a person must perform all worship purely for the sake of Allah alone, without making any partners with him. And having ikhlas in the ibadah, avoiding all types of shirk. Ikhlas al-ibada lillah wahda, alone, without making any partners with him. And the second of them, it is throwing away or repudiating or rejecting a shirk. And performing worship for Allah alone and rejecting every and any type of shirk. Then he says, يعني the explainer of the book, he says, قال المصنف, يعني he means the author, Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, has said, يعني in another place, أصل الدين وقاعدته, يعني the essence or the foundation of the deen and the basis or the foundation of the being, the